Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Dr. Harpreet Singh from the Department of Business Management, Guru Nanak Dev University's regional campus at Gurdaspur. Today we are going to talk on module Organizational Behavior, Meaning and Concepts under the paper Organizational Behavior. After completing this module, the students will be able to define organizational behavior, describe the scope of OB, list the key elements of OB, discuss about the approaches of OB. Today's business is preoccupied with the human resources. Human beings play a very vital role in the growth of the organizations, individually as well as in the groups. Though history of management depicts that in the earlier times, organizations used to consider non-human resources such as money, machinery, methods, and material more important than human resources. But now, this philosophy has been changed. Organizations have started realizing the importance of human resources. Organizations also understand that it is only human resource which possesses physical strength, administrative skills, decision-making skills, executive skills, and also organizing abilities. Such qualities must be optimally utilized and harnessed if organizational objectives are to be achieved. Therefore, OB has evolved as a relevant field of study. The organizational behavior focuses on all aspects of human nature and deals with human emotions, that is, how to motivate employees to increase performance, productivity, satisfaction, loyalty, and employee engagement. Also, it provides the methods to resolve conflicts. OB provides a common platform to work with peace and cooperation for the employees from different backgrounds, education, and perception. It also helps to manage the cultural diversity at work. An organization is an entity where various members work together to establish and achieve the common goals and objectives. Organizational behavior has been widely accepted as the area of study which is related with understanding, predicting, and controlling human behavior in organizations. Organizational behavior is a field of study which helps in understanding human behavior in an organizational context and also the interconnection between human behavior and growth of the organization. Scope of OB is very broad, which opens the doors to many other concepts like importance of OB and other fields of study, role and skills of managers, challenges in the organizational behavior, understanding people at work, individual groups and systems as building blocks, organizational behavior models, evolution of organizational behavior, researches in organizational behavior, and organizational behavior in international context, etc. All the above variables will be discussed in detail one by one in next modules.
Meaning and definitions of organization behavior. Organizational behavior is the study of individuals, groups, and organizational systems. Organizational behavior examines how human beings behave and interact with each other in the organizations. OB is considered as an art of applied science, which deals with the emotions, feelings, beliefs, perceptions, intellectuality, and mentality of people working in an organization. As human resource is a crucial factor which affects the growth of any organization, it becomes utmost important to understand how the behavior of people working in an organization can help it to grow. Organizational behavior studies an individual's capabilities in all aspects of work. It is the study of human behavior in organizations, the interface between human behavior and the organizations, and the organization itself. Understanding of the subject is absolutely imperfect without studying these three aspects carefully. OB establishes the linkages between human behavior in the organizational settings, individual organizational interface, and the environment surrounding the business. Nature of OB. Nature of OB can be well understood with the following definitions. Organization behavior is the study which is used to evaluate overall resources, that is physical resources and human resources, and helps to enhance the productivity of the organization. Organization behavior is a systematic study to examine the knowledge of individuals at work and their act within the organization. V.G. Kundalkar defined it as the study to investigate the impact of behavior on an individual, group of individuals, and organizational structure within the organization. The focus is given to enhance and apply such knowledge to gain organizational effectiveness. Further, he has divided the definition in three key elements. Organizational behavior is an investigative study of an individual or groups of individuals. The impact of organizational behavior studies on human behavior, the proper utilization of knowledge to achieve organizational goal effectively. L.M. Prasad also defined organizational behavior as the study of human knowledge related to elements of an organization such as internal and external environment or social system, superior in technology, and their flexibility to fit in the organization. According to Stephen P. Robbins, it is a systematic study within organization which is used to exhibit people attitude and their actions towards the work. Robbins further elaborated his definition by saying, it studies the impact on behavior of an individual or groups of individuals within the organization for the purpose to use the knowledge for the improvement of an organizational effectiveness. According to Clark, organizational behavior study means how an individual or a group of individuals act in the organization. Davis has defined organizational behavior as the overall study of human behavior, structure of organization, and their key elements, that is, technology, environment, and shape. Luthans defines OB is the combination of total interaction and their interdependency between both of them. After concluding all the definitions, it can be said that OB covers all three areas of human behavior in the organization: individuals, groups of individuals, and organization as a whole.
Fundamental concepts of OB. Organizational behavior is based on fundamental concepts which involve the nature of people and the nature of the organizations. The basic assumptions underlying the concept of OB are given as below. Individual differences. Every individual is different from another individual in terms of his or her intelligence, personality, physique, etc. The concept of individual differences has evolved from the field of psychology. It is assumed that every individual differs from another individual from the very first day of his or her birth. But unique experiences which the individual faces during different stages of life make him or her even more different. The concept of individual differences has motivated management to treat employees differently and find broad ways of dealing with employees. Good human relations. Organizational behavior has attempted to maintain interpersonal relationships between employees and employers. It provides directions regarding how to maintain good relations with employees and how to solve their problems. Effective organizational climate. OB stresses upon maintaining a good climate by developing sound interpersonal relations, hygienic working conditions, fair and adequate compensation, better and safe operation equipment, effective leadership, employee participation, etc. Motivation of human resources. Field of OB has motivated managers to motivate the employees by giving them various kinds of rewards and appreciate them on the basis of quality of work. Perception. Perceptions of people differ when they see an object in the similar way In organizations, employees see and perceive work differently. This is primarily because of their different personalities, needs, demographic factors, past experiences, and social surroundings. Desire for involvement. Every employee is actively seeking opportunities so as to involve himself or herself in decision making and to share what they know and to learn from the new experiences. Therefore, organizations should provide employees a chance to express their opinions, ideas, and suggestions for decision making problems. A meaningful involvement can bring mutual benefit to both the parties.
A whole person. When an organization recruits a new employee, only skills and qualities of that employee is not hired, but his or her social background, likes and dislikes, needs, motives, pride, motivations, and prejudices are also hired. Organizations accept the employees along with their personal lives and attempt to create away from home. Caused behavior. Human beings are rational beings, and therefore the behavior expressed by the employees in the organization is also caused and not random. Behavior of employees is always directed towards some goals or ends which suits their interest. The challenge for OB managers is to understand the cause behind a particular behavior of an employee and the ways to modify the behavior. Human dignity. The concept of human dignity is driven by ethical philosophy rather than the scientific principles of management. The concept guides that every individual should be treated with dignity and respect. The concepts also suggest that human beings are of higher order than other factors of production, and therefore, any comparison between human beings and non-human factors of production is not fair. This philosophy rejects the old philosophy of considering human resources as an economic tool. Organizations are social systems. Organizations are social systems, and therefore, their activities, policies, and procedures are governed by the social as well as psychological laws. Like individuals, organizations also have social norms and status. Growth and performance of the organizations are influenced by the behavior of groups and individual drives of people working in it. In every organization, two types of social systems run in parallel: formal system and informal social system. Mutuality of interest. This is represented by the fact that organizations need people and people need organizations. Both benefit each other in one or another way. People find organizations as a platform where they can find the channels to grow and reach their life and career goals. In the same way, organizations need people to achieve the organizational goals. Scope of organizational behavior. Organizational behavior encompasses the study of human behavior. The scope of organizational behavior includes the study of individual behavior, interpersonal behavior, and behavior of the organizations themselves. Key elements of organizational behavior. Organization is a group of people who work together to achieve a common goal by using their skills like managerial, task management, and interpersonal skills, and resources like physical resources as well as human resource. The term organization does not mean only by structure, design, and shape. It also includes the group of individuals which work independently to achieve organizational objectives effectively. To study deeply the concept of organization, it is necessary to understand the following key elements. First, people. Individuals working in an organization form the social system, which is internal to the organization. Social system of the organization is comprised of individuals and groups, large groups such as well as small groups. Individuals are the building blocks of the organizations and play a vital role in achieving the goals and objectives of the organization. Therefore, it is very important to understand, predict, and control the behavior of individuals working in the organizations. Structure and design of organization. Structure of an organization defines workflow and the relationship between people in the organization, interconnection of authority and responsibility, and division of work in an organization. Some important concepts of structure are given as below. Hierarchy of authority. It describes the distribution of authority among the different organizational positions. It also states the rights and responsibilities of a position holder. Division of labor. Division of labor describes the breakup of work into small tasks and assigning the tasks to the various members of the organization according to their abilities. Span of control. It refers to the optimum number of workers to be managed by a supervisor. Specialization. It refers to the idea of assigning the task to the concerned staff on the basis of qualifications. Standardization. It refers to following a set of rules or methods for routine activities. Organizations can be structured and designed as formalized and rigid systems or relatively flexible or loose systems. Structure of an organization can be of two types, formal structure and informal structure. Firstly, formal organization. Formal organizations mean formally organized enterprise where structure of role, authority, responsibility, and workflow is properly defined. Formal organizations are hierarchical in nature. Top managers can organize the organization well by inducing the congenial environment, which calls for individual performance, provides the opportunity for career growth, and contribute most effectively to the group goals. Informal organization. These organizations have neither any framed or specific structure nor hierarchical levels like formal organizations have. Informal organization represents the network of interpersonal relationships that emerge when people associate with each other. Therefore, informal organizations depict the relationships which do not appear on organizational charts. It does not matter what kind of organization an individual is working for. If there is free flow of information, effective communication system, that is verbal as well as written, authorities are well defined and given to responsible persons who can direct it in proper manner, the objectives can be achieved in an effective and convenient way. Hence, it is necessary that people on higher levels should be open-minded while dealing with their subordinates. Technology. Organizations use technology to convert their inputs into outputs. These technologies include knowledge of technical know-how, machinery, processes, and everything that is used in the transformation process. Managing technology to gain competitive advantages with global market and to maintain position in the local market is the biggest challenge for any organization. So, it is the duty of managers to enhance its equipment to innovative technology and should make up-to-date machines by upgrading and by procuring those from time to time. There are drastic changes happening in the technology day by day. So, organizations have to be flexible enough to adopt quickly and mold accordingly to survive in the market. According to Thomson, technology can be classified into three main categories. Firstly, long-lived technology. Such technology is used to divide tasks into a number of chronological steps. In such processes, output of one step becomes input for the next step. Such type of technology requires high level of specialization and standardization. Second is mediating technology. Mediating technologies bring together different parties together in a direct or indirect way. For example, banks use technology to install their ATM machines. For this, they may sign a contract with ATM manufacturing vendors. And then the third one is intensive technology. Such technology is used when a group of specialized people is brought together to solve a complex problem. Work environment. Every organization operates within an external environment which has a strong bearing on the decision making and growth of the organization. External environment is a blend of number of variables which mutually influence each other and the business as a whole. Work environment can be further divided into two categories, viz. Internal environment and external environment. Both the environments play a vital role in the business process. Firstly, internal environment. Internal environment is the combination of the factors which are internal to the business and are under the control of the management. Such factors primarily depict strengths and weaknesses of a business organization. Internal environment is comprised of organizational culture, vision, mission, objectives, top management, internal connections, ambience and technology, human resources, and leadership style. External environment. Outer or external environment is comprised of all other factors which are external to the business and which are beyond the control of management of the organization. Such factors significantly influence the inner environment and decision making of the business. External environment is made up of competitors, customers, suppliers, buyers, and involvement of governments, legal system, prevailing technology, and influence of political parties. All the above variables can affect the performance of internal culture of an organization.
Approaches. Four approaches of OB, that is human resources approach, productivity approach, contingency approach, and systems approach, will be discussed in this section. Approaches of organization behavior are the result of the researches done by the experts in this field. These experts studied and attempted to quantify research done about actions and reactions of employees with regard to their work environments. These approaches are discussed in detail in the following paragraphs. It may be stated that all these approaches are interwoven. Human resources approach. This approach is also called supportive approach. This approach recognizes human resources as crucial factor in the organizations and suggests the development of human resources towards the higher levels of their competency, creativity, and fulfillment. It is believed that developed people will contribute in the success of the organizations. According to this approach, the role of managers is not controlling the employees, but actively supporting them for their growth and performance. Human resources approach discards the traditional approach of management, which believes in close monitoring of the employees to ensure task accomplishment. Contingency approach. Contingency approach of OBE advocates that there are no uniform set of rules and methods for managing the behavior in the organizations. This means that there is no best way of managing people, but the best way can be identified on the basis of the prevailing situations and circumstances. Each situation has its own implications and should be handled accordingly. Therefore, the methods or behaviors which prove effective in one type of situation may fail in some other type of situation. In light of this, all the factors of the situation should be carefully analyzed, and then management style should be adopted. The main advantage of this approach is that it encourages a deep analysis of each situation before taking any decision and discourages the habitual practices. This approach is highly flexible and provides broad latitude to accept the differences in the situation.
Productivity approach. Productivity describes the output to input ratio of employees' performance. This ratio is treated as a measure of an organization's effectiveness. It also tells about the manager's efficiency in utilizing the organizational resources optimally. The higher the numerical value of this ratio, the greater is the efficiency. Productivity is generally measured in terms of economic inputs and outputs, both human and social inputs and outputs also are important. For example, when employee development programs lead to the making of better citizens in a community, a valuable social output occurs. Organizational behavior decisions usually involve human, social, and/or economic issues, and so productivity, usually a significant part of these decisions, is recognized and discussed extensively in the literature on organization behavior. Systems approach. Systems approach to organizational behavior considers the organization as a whole. This means that organization is a united, purposeful system composed of various interrelated subsystems. This approach provides a way of looking at the organization, a person, a group, and the social system as a whole. Systems approach tells us that the working of one part of the system affects the working of other parts of the system in varying degrees. Therefore, every person working in the organization should be viewed as a part of the system. The clerk at a service counter, the mechanist, and the manager all work with the people and therefore influence the quality of life in an organization and its inputs. In this case, managers have to take the larger responsibility because they are the ones who make majority of the decisions affecting human concerns.
So, students, let us now summarize what we have learned in this module. Organizational behavior is a field of study which helps in understanding human behavior in an organizational context and also the interconnection between human behavior and growth of the organization. Organizational behavior is the study of individuals, groups, and organizational systems. Organizational behavior examines how human beings behave and interact with each other in the organizations. OBE is considered as an art of applied science, which deals with the emotions, feelings, beliefs, perceptions, intellectuality, and mentality of people working in an organization. Key elements of OBE are people, structure, technology, and environment. In this module, four approaches of OBE, the human resource approach, the productivity approach, contingency approach, and systems approach have been discussed. Thank you.